Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to today's Caffeine for the Soul. I'm Michael Neill. You can read more about what I do at michaelneill.org. And this is the final part of our five-part conversation with Mara Gleason, author of the book One Thought Changes Everything, and the co-founder of One Solution, an international nonprofit dedicated to solving large-scale global issues by illuminating a new understanding of the mind. And that's what we're going to focus on today, is the One Solution Global Initiative, what it is, how it works, and how you can be part of the One Solution to global issues. One of the last chapters in the book, you share the notion that someday is just a thought, as a sort of a launch in to how you got going on the One Solution Initiative. And we did a whole radio show together, you and I was so moved by that story. So I don't want to kind of do that story here, but one of my favorite quotes, I don't remember, I'm sure I've told you this, is a Marianne Williamson quote where she says, "God heard us. He sent help. He sent you." And to me, when I think of the spirit behind the One Solution Initiative and what you and Eric are up to, I hear that. But I guess where I want to begin is with the question of sort of, well, what is, sort of like we started the podcast with, well, what thought changes everything? Well, one solution, what's the solution? And let's start with that. And then maybe we can kind of go towards the what one person can do part of it.
Yeah.
So what is the One Solution?
The One Solution is a new understanding of the mind. Because the one we currently collectively hold is harming us. Hmm. And I've applied for a variety of different grants for One Solution at this stage. And one of the sentences I shared when we applied for the MacArthur grant for $100 million, which we did not get, shame, was, "We're not at war with each other. We're at war with a misunderstanding of the mind." And I really feel that. I don't think that humans, I don't even want to say think, I want to go ahead and just say it. I know the humans would not be involved in any of the wars, both interpersonal and personal, that we're involved in right now if we had a new understanding of the mind. Mm. And I know that because I've seen it happen to so many people, that when they gained a new understanding of the mind, the suffering cleared up. The suffering cleared up organizationally, the suffering cleared up interpersonally, and the suffering cleared up internally, inside their own minds about themselves. And so having seen that happen on a small and a large scale with so many different people over the last 12 years of doing this work, it just dawned on me, this would solve all the world's problems. If people quit mistaking their experience as happening to them from the outside, then we would be okay. Because that's the only thing that causes suffering.
Well, let's look to the understanding, because one of the things that I see people do when they start to hear about this whole inside out notion of how experience gets created is that they almost use it to imprison themselves in terrible circumstances. Mm. Well, look, it's not my boyfriend beating me. It's my thinking. So I should just change my thinking. Oh, it's not that they're bombing my country. It's my thinking. So we should just let them bomb our country. I mean, you're taking it to the obvious, ridiculous extreme. Mm-hmm. So what's different about the inside out understanding of how the mind works to that idea that I should just take it? It's my fault. It's my thinking.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's interesting. I think that's something that could only be kind of said by someone who hadn't actually learned it for themselves. Because everyone that I've worked with who's had that realization that truly everything comes from their mind experiences this enormous updraft in freedom and capability and energy in their lives. So only when people feel better and feel more freedom of mind can they have the intelligence and the energy available to them to change their situation, to leave an abusive partner, to And honest to God, I mean, on my own whole, again, just the scale of humanity, my own version of that scale, that was what happened to me when Adik said, someday's just a thought, is I got out of the prison of the single thought that I had that somehow the world's problems were external to me and there was nothing I could do about them. So they were someday going to get fixed by somebody else, you know,
right.
Like... one solution was born of that freedom of mind and the energy that comes from that updraft of realizing, oh my God, I made that up. That's inside my mind too. Even that.
Yeah.
And so everyone, myself included, that I've come across that's had a moment of realization of, oh my gosh, I'm experiencing my own mind, not that thing out there, gets more powerful.
Well, so in a way where the solution is not the idea or even the understanding, it's the insight.
Right. It's the realization.
Yeah.
Of that understanding. That understanding as a, you know, I think of when you go to offices and they have like their
motivational slogans.
Yeah, exactly. Like, we pride ourselves on these following blah, blah, blah. It's like on, as a statement, as a bumper sticker, as a thing, it's nothing.
Yeah. You're right.
It has no juice to it. But as a realization, it has everything the world needs and more.
Well, and it kind of speaks to, not to make this entire thing circular and about your book, but it comes back to, well, one thought changes everything. That actually when you see that, even to, in my experience, when you even glimpse it, it does actually change everything, because you're no longer navigating a fixed reality, a fixed world, trying to handle it differently.
Right.
And that's a whole different game.
Right. You're literally reinventing the world for yourself, and then you can do differently in that new world.
Yeah. It reminds me, years ago, one of the first jobs I ever had when I started studying NLP and behavioral modeling was being sent to work with the Silicon Valley troubleshooter. And you know, who was this great problem solver, and he'd be sent out to solve these huge problems. And so my first question, you know, rookie cub reporter, Jimmy Olsen, you know, okay, so what do you do when you get a really difficult problem? And he said, oh, I don't solve difficult problems. And I said, well, what do you mean? I've been hired to, because you're so good at, and he said, no, if a problem looks difficult to me, I know I've defined it wrong.
Mm.
And while I saw that in quite a linear strategic way at the time, in the context of what I've seen since and the conversation you and I are having, in a way, what he's saying is, yeah, no, this reality is not working for me. What else you got? And when I get a reality that I know what to do, then I'll do it.
Yes. Which really is another way of defining what is the solution. Is the solution is shifts in consciousness, which to your point is the realization of a new
yeah.
the mind, as opposed to just an understanding of the mind getting handed out on pieces of paper to people. It's like, no, you have to have a realization of that. And that's that black box moment, is it's a shift in consciousness. Now, I stay away from that phrase too much because I don't even really know how to define that.
Sure.
But I do know Einstein talked about it. You know, you can't solve a problem from the same level of consciousness that created it or the same level of thinking that created it. And that's what, you know, your Silicon Valley problem solver guy was saying, is the state of the world right now is just a bunch of people trying to solve problems in the same level of consciousness that created them. And it doesn't work that way.
Well, it's I mean, in a way, another way of talking about that shift in consciousness, it's that moment where nothing's changed, but everything's different.
Yeah.
And that is an experience that everyone I've ever talked to has examples of, even if they've never connected the dots back to, well, no, that's actually just how it works. as opposed to a fluky thing.
Well, and that's what I love about having a set of universal principles that can actually be shared. Because it takes, like, imagine if you're to say to, you know, all of the top leaders of the world right now, all of those amazing innovators, entrepreneurs that are looking at the biggest global challenges of our time. And so, look, they're all just symptoms of a level of consciousness, and we cannot solve these problems at this same level of consciousness. Then you get like, well, how do you change the level of consciousness of the world then? Well, actually, good news. There's a universal set of principles that explains that. That's why it looks like a solution to me.
Turns out there's a manual. Who knew? Yeah.
Fear not.
All right. So let's maybe finish this with your, and I, and answer it as you will, but sort of your hopeful vision for humanity. Mm. You know, where do you see this going? Given that, of course, it's all up for grabs, but you know, what would be cool?
What would be cool is if humanity experienced a shift in consciousness, where exactly like you said, nothing would change, but everything would be different. And so we'd still be our normal human being selves. We'd be waking up every day doing our human thing, but we would see the world so differently that we would be creating in the world so differently. So we wouldn't be creating inequality and racism and violence and environmental destruction. I really do see clearly that all of those things are a symptom of the state of consciousness that the world is in right now. And to take it away from, again, because I personally have like a little bit of a phobia of that term state of consciousness, but just the level of understanding about how life is created. Mm. If we change the understanding of how life is created, where people weren't feeling victimized by a world out there, but instead realize that it's all created from this internal capacity to have thought, and we are free to have new thinking in any moment. We are literally one thought away from a different reality and a different world. And if people knew that, the world we would all create collectively would look very different than the one we're creating right now.
I hope you've really enjoyed this series. If you want to learn more about Mara and the work that she's doing in the world, you can go to onesolutionglobal.org and, of course, pick up a copy of her wonderful new book, One Thought Changes Everything. I'll be back with a brand new episode next week. Until then, have fun, learn heaps, and I'll talk to you soon. We'll be right back.